Hi, I'm Robin Whalley, welcome to Lenscraft. Today, I'm looking at how to change the colour of an object using the Affinity Photo Colour Replacement Brush Tool. Now there's lots of ways to change or replace the colour of an object in Affinity Photo. What makes this tool so good is that it's extremely easy to use and it creates very convincing results. To demonstrate, I'll be replacing the red of this boat with green. You'll find the Colour Replacement Brush tool grouped with the Paintbrush and the Pixel tools in the Tools palette. If you can't see the Colour Replacement Brush, you may find one of these other tools is showing instead. But if you click on the icon and hold your mouse button, the other tools will appear. You can then click on the Colour Replacement Brush to select it. But before you use the Colour Replacement Brush, you should take a moment to configure the brush options. Now I'm going to start by setting the brush to have 100% opacity, 100% flow and 100% hardness. This is going to make it easier for me to work more precisely with the brush. I can always modify these later if I need to deal with particular problem areas. Next, I'll pick the replacement colour to paint using the Swatches Studio panel. It's also possible to make an exact colour replacement if you know the RGB value or the HSL value of the colour you want to use. If you double-click on the active colour, you can open the Colour Chooser dialog where you can enter the colours to use for the replacement. But for this example, I'm just going to use one of the colours in the colour swatch. Next, I'll set my tolerance to around 30%. The tolerance controls how wide a colour range the brush replaces when you paint. A high tolerance means the brush replaces a wider range of colours. If I set a lower tolerance, it makes the brush more precise and it replaces only colours that are a really near match to the area I'm painting over. This is neither good or bad. You'll probably need to keep adjusting the tolerance as you paint to get the best results. You'll see what I mean when we look at some of the more difficult areas in this image. Having configured the brush and selected the colour I want to paint with, I can now paint over the red areas of the boat to replace them with the green. But before I make any changes, I want to duplicate my image layer. The colour replacement brush is a destructive edit and paints directly onto the pixel layer, replacing colours. For this reason, I like to paint onto a duplicate layer in case I make serious mistakes. I can duplicate the image layer by right-clicking with my mouse and selecting Duplicate from the pop-up menu. If I had multiple layers making up my image, I'd create a new stamp layer which consolidates all the visible layers into a new layer. You can create a stamp layer using the keyboard shortcut Shift, Option, Command and E if you're using a Mac. If you're using a PC, it's Shift, Control, Alt and E. One of the great features of this brush is that it creates a preview as you move it over the boat. This helps me plan the adjustments that I want to make to the boat without actually applying them. I can use this to check the colour I want to use looks the way that I think it will. More importantly though, I can check the configuration settings will correctly select and replace the red on the boat in each area. I'm therefore going to check an area where I want to replace the colour first. If this looks good, I can click and begin to paint over that area. Even though I'll try to keep close to the edge of the boat, it's possible I could spill over the edge and affect other areas. If you do find this happening to you, it's best to undo the change and make the brush stroke again. But if you don't spot the error in time, you can fix it later. I'll show you how to do this later in the video. Now let's look at replacing the red reflection of the boat on the water. I'll zoom into the area so you can better see it and I can also work with a bit more precision. Looking at the area, the red reflection presents a bit of a challenge because I want to avoid affecting the water when I replace the red with the green. If I reduce the tolerance down to around 10%, the brush will become more accurate as I paint. Even then, however, I could still affect the water if I don't keep the centre of the brush over the red. What's happening is that the brush is sampling a colour as I pass over it and then using that sample to determine which colours to replace. This behaviour is controlled by the Sample Continuously option in the toolbar. When the option's ticked, the colour replacement brush continually samples as you paint. If I unselect the option, the brush now takes a single sample when I first click, and it retains that sample for as long as I hold the mouse button down. I can now continue to replace the red in the other areas of the boat. When I come to an area which has a lot of variation in the red, I can either increase the tolerance or set the sampling to continuous. By using the tolerance together with the sampling option, I can create a convincing and accurate colour replacement. I'll just finish the painting and then I'll show you how to clean up any mistakes. Earlier, I made a mistake where I affected the colour of the water near to the boat. The way that I'm going to fix this is by adding a mask to the layer that I've been working on. Then I'll use a black brush to paint onto the mask in the areas where I want to hide the adjustment. If I make another mistake and reveal some of the red on the boat, I can fix it using either the undo command or paint on the mask with white to reveal the green again. With a little care, it's possible to create a very realistic colour change. I hope you found this video helpful. There's also a written tutorial to accompany it which you'll find on my website. I'll include a link to this in the YouTube video description. I'm Robin Whalley, you've been watching Lenscraft. I'll see you next week for another video.